Ladies and gentlemen, it's the Lawrence Welk Show, celebrating more than 50 years on television. Now sit back and enjoy the show, selected especially for public television.
Hi, everyone. I'm Mary Lou Metzger, your host for this Lawrence Welk Show. This week, the cast is singing songs of the 70s, and the show was taped in 1978. That was the year Affirmed won the Triple Crown, Debbie Boone recorded You Light Up My Life, the Bee Gees had that big hit Stayin' Alive, and John Travolta and Olivia Newton-John sang You're the One That I Want from Grease. In 1978, people were watching their favorite television programs, Three's Company, Charlie's Angels, and Little House on the Prairie. And on Broadway, Liza Minnelli was doing the act, and Ain't Misbehavin' won the Tony Award. In this Lawrence Welk Show salute to the 70s, you'll see a great Guy and Ralna musical moment on I Write the Songs. Bob Ralston has a wonderful version of Southern Nights. Bobby's first partner, Barbara Boylan, joins him for I Could Have Danced All Night. And Sandi, Gail, and I team up for Penny Arcade, which was a hit for Christy Lane. The three of us are holding stuffed animals, and you might notice Sandy's is a little bigger than Gail's and mine. You guessed it, Sandi was expecting. Just another example of our fabulous costumer, Rose Weiss, being her creative self. So let's go on with the show, featuring songs of the 70s.
From Hollywood, it's the Lawrence Welk Show. Lawrence Welk!
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very kindly. Greetings, friends, and a warm welcome. Listen to that beautiful audience this evening. Our show this evening features the top songs of the 70s. And let's get things started with a song you folks all know. A one and two and a...
Sullivan with a song from the movie Mahogany, which starred Diana Ross. It was also a hit recording for that talented young lady, and it's very popular with the younger sets.
Do you know where you're going to? Do you like the things that life is showing you? Where are you going to?
Nights. Thank you, Kathie. Here's a good song titled Southern Nights, a recording hit for Glenn Campbell and also for organist Lenny Diem. And here's our own fine organist, Bob Ralston. Songs of the 70s are natural for our talented young quartet, the Otwell Twins and the Aldridge Sisters. Kids, before you sing, bring the folks up to date about yourselves.
We'd like to tell you a little bit about ourselves this evening. We're the Otwell Brothers. I'm David.
And I'm Roger.
And we're from Tulia, Texas, a little town up in the Texas Panhandle. Jack Love, a local businessman in Tulia, wrote Mr. Welk a letter, and that's how we became acquainted with Mr. Welk. And we'd always hoped to be in show business, and it was really a great honor for us when Mr. Welk invited us to be on the show.
And we're the Aldridge Sisters. I'm Sherry.
And I'm Sheila.
And probably most of you know us as the Aldridge Sisters from Knoxville, Tennessee. But actually, we were born in two small cities in western North Carolina, Marion and Spruce Pine.
And then later, we moved to Lexington Park, Maryland, and then finally to Tennessee, which is where we met Mr. Welk, and we're so happy that we did. We'd like to do a song for you folks tonight. It just so happens that this year for the Country Music Awards, they voted the Oak Ridge Boys as the best instrumental group of the year, as well as the best vocal group. And we'd like to do one of their best songs for you right now.
You're the one in a million. You're the one, you're the one, you're the one. To show. Oh, and many's the time I have stood at the crossroads, not knowing which way to go. You're the one in a million. You're the one, you're the one, you're the one in a million. I see. You're the one in a million. You're the one. You're the one.
young people. Thank you, kids. Folks, here's a little surprise. You folks remember Barbara Boylan? Well, she's back with us this evening. And here she is to join her former partner, Bobby Burgess. Barbara and Bobby. Tom, tell the folks about your contribution to this 70s show.
Well, certainly one of the most popular singing groups of the 70s was the Carpenters, and here's one of their more recent hits. Hope you like it.
There's someone in this crazy world for me. The way that people come and go through temporary lives, my chance might come and I might never know. I used to say no promises, let's keep it simple, but freedom only helps you say goodbye. It took a while for me to learn that nothing comes for free. The price I pay is high enough for me. I know I need to be in love. I know I've wasted too much time. I know I ask perfection of a quite imperfect world, and I'm fool enough to think that's what I'll find. I know I need to be in love. I know I've wasted too much time. I know I ask perfection of a quite imperfect world. when I'm fool enough to think that's what I'll find. I'm fool enough to think that's what I'll find.
Country music is becoming more popular all the time, and so is our country gal, Ava Barber. Here she is with the song that recently won an award as the country's song of the year.
Don't know where I've been so blue. Don't know what's come over you. Found someone new, and don't it make my brown eyes blue? I'll be fine when you're gone. I'll just cry all night long. Say it is untrue. But don't say goodbye. I didn't mean to treat you bad. Didn't know just what I had. But honey, now I do.
One song of 1975, and this arrangement features our excellent young trumpet man, Johnny Zell.
Thank you.
beautiful song, and Johnny Zell, that was really beautiful. Sandy Gale and Mary Lou bring you one of the newer hits, a song recorded by Christy Lane that's close to the top of today's hit parade.
If I had a penny every time you told a lie and made me cry for you, I could spend a lifetime in a penny arcade. If I had a penny every time you did me blue and hurt me through and through, I could spend a lifetime in a penny arcade. Every day I walk away and try to kiss you bye-bye, baby.
Beautiful melody was written for the theme of the television show The Young and the Restless. In the 1976 Olympic, a 16-year-old Romanian girl won a gold medal and the hearts of the world. Using this music for her performance, George, let's hear Nacha's theme. Thank you.
Gail Farrell and our singers. Just beautiful. Among the hit songs of the 70s, I kind of like the country hit Never Ending Song of Love. So Bob Smale, let's have a beat.
Duncan. Some of the top songs of the 70s have come out of Nashville, the country music capital of the world. This next song by Nashville composers Bob McDill and Wayne Hollyfield was a big hit for country star Don Williams. And here's everybody's friend, Jimmy Roberts.
She packed up her suitcase and walked to the door. She said she won't come back like she's done before. I bet she's in Dallas before it gets dark. And I know she's thinking she's breaking my heart. She knows I love her, so she thinks I'll cry. She never knew me, she never knew me, she never knew me at all. Then like a lost child, she'll wanna come home. She thinks I'm waiting there by the phone. She'll stop in some cafe, give me a call, but she never knew me, she never knew me, she never knew me at all. She never knew me.
Our good friend Perry Como had a hit recording of a Latin song under the English title, It's Impossible. Anacani gives you both the English and Spanish words.
It's impossible, tell the sun to leave the sky, it's just impossible. Cry, it's just impossible.
Singer and composer Neil Sedaka made a big comeback in the past few years with several hit songs, including this one, Laughter in the Rain. Let's listen to our sensational saxophone section and Bob Smale at the keyboard. A one, two, and
two basic misconceptions about the song we're going to do now. This was Song of the Year, 1976. First misconception is that it was written by Barry Manilow. It wasn't. Yeah. He recorded it and sold about 8 zillion records, but Bruce Johnston wrote this song, and it's called I Write the Songs. The second misconception about it is that it was written by a songwriter who's saying, I write the songs that makes the whole world sing. Yeah. Not true.
No,
it's the songwriter's writing in the third person, and he's writing as if he were music telling a story. You understand?
Sing, guys.
I didn't think so.
I've been alive forever, and I wrote the very first song. Words and the melodies together. I am music and I write the songs. I write the songs that make the whole world sing. I write the songs of love and special things. I write the songs that make the young girls cry. I write the songs, I write the songs.
My home lies deep within you. I've got my own blaze in your soul. And when I look out through your eyes, I'm young again, even though I'm very old.
It's for me.
It's for you.
It's from you.
It's for me.
It's a one-one symphony.
I write the songs that make the whole world sing. I write the songs.
This next song was a big recording for the late James Croce, Jim Croce, back in 1973, all about a very suspicious character named Bad Bad Leroy Brown. You know how to stop this song? He is stopping it.
Well, the south side of Chicago is the baddest part of town. And if you go down there, you better just beware of a man named Leroy Brown. Now, Leroy, more than trouble. You see, he stands about 6'4". All the downtown ladies call him treetop lover. All the men just call him sir. And he's bad, bad Leroy Brown, the baddest man in the whole downtown. Badder than old King Kong and meaner than a junkyard dog. Oh, yeah. Now they're stopping. The father sat a girl named Doris, and oh, that gal looked nice. Well, he cast his eyes upon her, and the trouble soon began. And Leroy Brown learned a lesson about messing with the wife of a jealous man. Now the two men, they took to fighting, and when they pulled them from the floor, well, Leroy looked just like a jigsaw puzzle with a couple of pieces gone. The baddest man in the whole darn town, badder than old King Kong, and meaner than a junkyard dog. Say he was badder than old King Kong, and meaner than a junkyard dog.
Well, we sure had pennies swinging there. Folks, would you believe that a polka was one of the top songs of the 70s? Yes, it was the Bobby Vinton hit, My Melody of Love. Myron, give it that happy treatment. Here's one of the prettiest songs of the 70s, which Joe Feeney in the Solar Spot arranged and conducted by Bob Ballard.
But I won't let
tell them I don't know, I guess they'll understand how lonely life has been. But life began again the day you took my hand. And yeah,
gentlemen, thank you all so much. Well, folks, that does it for this evening. Thank you all so very, very much for joining us. Let's make it a date for next week when we bring you a winter show. So long now. Have a nice week.
Watching Myron Florin on that number brings back so many memories for me. We all know what a great musician Myron was. But he was also quite a gentleman. Many years ago, Myron and I were on a red-eye flight out of Los Angeles with connections in Chicago. Well, I had a couple of hours layover, and I just assumed he did too. He said I'd be a lot more comfortable in the VIP lounge than sitting at the gate at 3 a.m. So he walked me there and used his membership to check me in. At that point, he said he had to run because his plane was about to board in another terminal. He'd gone so far out of his way just to see that I was taken care of. I'll never forget his kindness. They don't make them like that anymore. Tie a Yellow Ribbon was such a big hit in the 70s, and I thought the band outdid themselves on that one. Even Lawrence couldn't keep his feet still. Bob Havens, our fabulous Dixieland trombone player, was recently honored as Emperor of the Sacramento Jazz Festival. And Henry Cuesta was one of the finest, most dedicated musicians I've ever known. So before we go, watch this preview of coming attractions on The Welk Show. ¶¶
nestle the fine romance you won't wrestle. I might as well be home with my old maid aunts. I haven't got a chance. This is a fine romance.
The moon is shining. Oh, happy night. Come to me, darling, and hold me oh so tight. I need your loving, really, yes, I do.
Those are just a few musical moments you'll be seeing here in the coming weeks. Thank you for watching and supporting this public television station, who faithfully bring you the Lawrence Welk Show every week. So as Lawrence Welk always said, keep a song in your heart.